month from now, NBC will decide which series go on to another season this fall and which on the bubble may drop. One of those on the bubble, as we say in TV terms, is The Mystery of Laura, starring Deborah Messing in the role of a cop with a family to take care of as well. The show runs on NBC Wednesday nights at 8 o'clock. In a moment, we will have one of the co-stars of the show join us live here in our studio. But right now, let's see her in action. She's making a phone call, or should say a BlackBerry call, to one of her co-stars at police headquarters.
Uh-huh.
Alysia, hey, it's Jake Broder.
Uh-huh.
I heard something about no talking.
That's right, it was silent reading time.
Well, that makes perfect sense. I didn't know about the reading.
Right, oh, well, you know what? While we're on that subject, if I were you, I'd work on that out loud reading time, too.
What does that mean?
I mean, your two little princes over there are a little bit behind the eight ball on their basic reading skills. When my kids were young, I worked 60 hours a week, and I read all the Harry Potter books to them. Out loud. They read a page, I read a page, Hogwarts, Hagrid's, the whole nine yards. And I hate Harry Potter.
Thank you for the suggestion.
Oh, no, no, no. See, that was more than a suggestion. This situation is at a DEFCON 2.
Alysia, could I give you a little feedback?
Mm-hmm.
You might want to lighten up a bit.
Well, how does that work? Am I supposed to just flash my pearly white smile and give your borderline illiterate children whatever they want?
That sounds a little like sarcasm.
Oh, you got me. You must be a detective. Listen, I gotta go.
Who hates Harry Potter?
And joining us live in our studio, co-star of The Mysteries of Laura, Alysia Joy Powell. Welcome in.
Hey, how you doing?
Very well, thank you. Love that scene. You made BlackBerry very happy.
That's cool, because most of the people use Apple products, so, yeah.
Well, the police lieutenant got the Apple, I think. I can see that from the way the cell phone went. How are things going with Mysteries of Laura?
Amazing. I love, love, love Mysteries of Laura. I am with an amazing cast. I couldn't ask for better. And the writers. The writers love me. I love them. I mean, it's a great partnership.
I checked, by the way, on Wikipedia, because they have an episodic list of your show, the writers and the directors you have on, also the people who created the program, and you got some good producers, including Warner Brothers,
who
put the show together.
Yes, and Warner Brothers loves us. Let's hope they love us a lot, you know, for the second, you know, renewal.
Mm-hmm. And one of your directors, incidentally, was Michael Schultz, who did The Night Story, and also did Car Wash.
Charles Schultz, yes, Michael Schultz. Michael Schultz is amazing. He's a legend in his own time. I mean, gosh, he did Coolie High, he did Car Wash, he did all of Richard Pryor's movies. Amazing guy.
One of the great pioneers, by the way, of African-American cinema.
Yes.
And general cinema, too.
I didn't get a chance to work with him that much, though, on that episode, because I wasn't in there very much. So I missed him, but I do keep up with him on Facebook.
How did you get the role?
Okay, that's a long start. Okay, first, my agent was submitting me for like two-word auditions, which I was not happy with, you know, considering my resume. But I said, okay, you know what? We're going to go in here and we're going to do this one. So I went in there and I just forgot about the script and I just did my thing. And they wanted me.
Why was it important for you to do this role? What about the role and about the series that you liked that said, I must be in this program?
Well, actually, they picked me. After we did the pilot, they created a character for me. They brought me back because I wasn't supposed to be a part of the original cast. So they made a place for me. They contacted my agent and said they wanted me, and they wasn't sure where they wanted me to be. So I said, I got on Twitter and got with Mac G, who was the director, and said, hey, the kids need a nanny. So they brought me back as the nanny, and they blessed me with making her my character name, Alysia. So... yeah, it started there.
So it's a name after you.
Yes.
And you play a nanny.
I do.
To the two sons that Deborah Messing has.
Yes, they were badass kids.
Mm-hmm. Sounds that way.
But I got them together. I got them together. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Did you draw upon any experiences of nanny-ish or your family in terms of shaping the role?
No, actually not. I'm very maternal anyway. I don't have kids, but I'm good with kids. I'm very maternal. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. And after the pilot, I really didn't have a chance to bond with the kids. I bonded with Deb, you know, of course, Josh. But when I came back, that's when I really got a chance to know the twins. They are adorable.
As I noted at the top, when NBC showed clips of this series to the press, to advertisers at their fall program preview, a lot of people were like, this would be one of the first shows that's going to go under the knife. It's not going to last.
They hated the pilot. They hated the pilot. I mean, they said the reviews were horrible. I was just like horrified. But it's true. The pilot was kind of all over the place. And most people say, like, you probably shouldn't air the pilot because you're just trying to fill it out. And we're a new show, and we're still trying to fill it all out, you know, figure out where everybody lands and, you know, what's working for the show. We've come a long way since the pilot, and they've gotten it together, and the writing is very strong.
And somebody must have noticed, because the public, at least, has taken on to the point where, as I mentioned, the ratings have the best that NBC has had. Remember, NBC last year had Revolution, which went from Monday night at 10, where it was a hit, to Wednesday at 8, where it was a bomb. Your show fills in, and you're getting better audience, better viewership than Revolution ever did.
Can I tell you that that Wednesday night, I don't know who came up with that, but that was genius. You know, that's a perfect time slot. Our 8 o'clock time slot doesn't conflict with Empire. Thank God. So we have no chance of being canceled, being up against Empire.
And you're not up against it now because they wrapped up their episodes.
Yes, thank God. I love Empire, by the way. But that night is just a hot night for, you know, mystery or for cop shows, because you have the three ladies back to back. You started out with something very light and very funny, and then you followed up with two heavy dramas.
Law and Order SVU, and then Chicago.
Chicago PD,
And in fact, NBC has started to, I believe early this year, they have done some cross-promotion campaigns where they've involved all three shows.
Yes,
they don't
leave
you out in the dark. They put, you know, all together.
That's how
Deborah,
they promoted
it. Deborah, Mariska,
it.
And the PD people.
Yes. It's just wonderful, and it's brilliant. Whoever came up with that, they knew what they were doing. Because it works. It just works for that night. I can't see, like, Mysteries being on another night where it would fit so perfectly. Mm-hmm.
Alysia Joy Powell is one of the co-stars of The Mysteries of Law. It's on Wednesday nights at 8 o'clock on NBC, and she is with us live in our studio this half hour on Tomorrow Be Televised. Simon Appleban with you live from Brooklyn Penn Media near the Barclays Center in New York. Happy you're with us on this April Monday. You want to get involved in the show? Very simple. You give us a call, 646-652-2906, or use our chat room, Simon Apple 04 by name. Oh, Rick Webb, our friend from Philadelphia, already in the room. Other people as well. Coming up on Friday's program, we'll highlight a series that's been on local New York television the last 2 years. It's about to go national. It's on WWR TV, and it's called Ride With Me. We'll have the executive producer, Gabasa Diacosta. She will be with us live, maybe in studio. That's this Friday, 3 p.m. Eastern, noon Pacific, right here on Tomorrow Will Be Televised. How is it like on the set now compared to the beginning, where there was the concern about, are we going to get past the pilot to, well, we're in the hunt. We may be on the bubble, but we are in the hunt to get a second season.
Well, everybody was very tense. Everything was very, very tense, because you didn't know from one episode to another if we were going to be there. Now things are a little bit relaxed. I think we'll let down our britches a little bit more after we get renewed for another season.
And how'd you contribute to a better relaxed environment on the set?
You know what? I like to be personable. So I don't spend a whole lot of time in my dressing room. I spend a lot of time on the set. I talk to everybody, hair, makeup, crew, you know, the executive producers. I'm very much involved that way personally with everybody. So I know everybody. It's a big family.
Deborah Messing, what's it like working with her as well as the other people?
She's a saint. I love her. We kind of fell in love at first sight. Mm-hmm. Actually, she's the one of the people who'd asked for me to come back after the pilot. Mm. Yeah, she's like, this girl works. Bring her back. We need her.
Sounds like Deborah on down with the cast has a lot of clout.
Oh, yes. Well, she's a star. Mm-hmm. I mean, the reason why I believe we're still on the air is because of her fans. She has some diehard fans, and I've acquired some of those diehard fans. I mean, some of my friends on Twitter, now they have a campaign for us to stay on the air. They've drawn up videos and everything for us to get us renewed. They're sending to the executive producers.
What kind of videos? How are they, like, giving you feedback? How are they, like, supporting you?
They, like, I don't know where they get this stuff from. They get, like, clips of pictures of us and everything, and they put it in, like, a montage with music and everything. And then somebody had a petition going for the network. It's been amazing, and it's been a lot of great feedback for my character.
Mashup City. Incidentally, something else. The show got a People's Choice Award.
Yes.
A nomination for People's
Choice. Nomination.
Right. Nomination.
Next year we'll get an award.
And you had good competition. And you were actually in, I believe, comedy. As
yes.
opposed to drama, even though we were an hour-long show.
Well, that's the funny thing. I think to get in, so they can get their hour show in, we were listed as a drama. But it's comedy.
Mm-hmm. Is this the first time you've worked with kids?
No. No, I've worked... Kids and animals are tough. And I've worked with both.
All right, but what animals do they remind you of? You stepped into that.
Actually, Deb is a tiger. Mm-hmm. You know, if you've seen her, if you've ever worked with her, she's amazing. She has great senses. She knows how to do the shot selection. She knows how to set up the scene. She's there coaching on the set. Sometimes I catch her mouthing my dialogue and stuff. She's amazing. She really
is. Matter of fact, here we are with the original poster for the show that most people saw here in New York and around the country, where she's like collaring the bad guys with one arm and collaring the kids with the other.
Yeah, because the kids were bad before I came, yes. And then that wonderful Laz Alonso, he is delicious.
So you guys have a lot of fun on the set, which, incidentally, the program is shot here in New York. Where do you?
It is, at Silver Cup.
Which is
and
like
then all over border. The city, because we do, thank God I'm with the kids, so I'm at home. I'm at Silver Cup all the time, and they do a lot of location shoots. And I say thank God because one time, like the worst, coldest day that we had, they had to shoot on the Intrepid. Outside on the water. And I was like, oh my gosh.
Right near the Hudson, 53rd
yes.
Street.
Yes, I just sent tweets. I hope you guys are warm.
Did you do a lot of shooting in, I think in the pilot, there was a bit of shooting in here in Brooklyn.
Actually, we shot, we always shoot a lot in Brooklyn, but we shot my scenes in Central Park. Mm. Yeah, at the bridge. Mm-hmm. It's so pretty.
How cool. Do you know, what, on the Central Park west side or down on Fifth Avenue?
On the west side. On the west side. Yeah, right by the lake that they have there with the bridge. It's beautiful.
You were talking about Empire before, and certainly that is an extraordinary success story.
Yes.
To go from where it was at the beginning, and every week the ratings improved. And and I had the chance to see the last two episodes here in Brooklyn at Bedford Hall, down at Bedford Avenue. And it was amazing, the crowd reaction. But here's a program where it's like every single scene ends in a cliffhanger.
It does.
And like cliffhanger, cliffhanger, cliffhanger all the way.
Right.
And also the talent that they had in that program, Debbie Allen, John Singleton, of course,
yes.
was on a program when she did Game Change.
Yeah.
Lee Daniels, of course, the butler.
The directors, Mario Van Peebles.
Who did one of the last episodes.
Yes, and Mr. Hamilton that did Red Wing. Red Tails. Amazing collaboration of talent. To have directors every week like that, powerhouses come through, that's pretty amazing.
What do you think about this incredible jump up in diversity on the broadcast networks? Empire on Fox, Black-ish, and now American Crime on ABC. Other shows, other places. Your character, of course, and what's going on with Mysteries of Laura.
Yes.
Not to mention, you know, many other shows on NBC. Plus, what's in the pipeline in terms of pilots that are out to become series this summer or this fall? Well, what you're thinking about, you know,
Empire,
seeing all this diversity all, you know, happen on broadcast at the same time?
I love it, for one, because I get a check. But Empire has definitely changed the game, where we can show that we bring advertising dollars to the table. And it's always a matter of, you know, are we viable as a market? But I think, like, TV is just boring without us, you know? And who lives in a world, especially in New York, without Black folks? Come on. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, to see such diversity is pretty exciting. And most of them are my friends. So I'm rooting for them, you know? Mm-hmm.
Have you seen American Crime?
I have not. You know what? I saw it. I'm trying to get into it. It's a little slow for me. Like, I'm not sure how to get into it. I'm not sure what to think about it yet. So it's taking me a little time.
One of the most interesting experiences, Alysia, was to see the two of the first three episodes, both of them written by John Ridley, one directed by him.
Yes.
At 168th Street in Manhattan, where Malcolm X was assassinated. And to see in that place with Spike Lee, with everyone who was present, and to see people react to that program, which is, to me, I think the most brilliant thing ABC has done in years since NYPD Blue. It's a confronting show. It is a show that's not easy to get into. It's a show where you really are challenged to see, like, where do you stand on things? How do you react to people? How are you being with people? How does an incident tick you off? And it's extraordinary, and it's like every week the episodes get better on every single level, and I think no matter what happens, ABC should get tremendous credit for putting its gut out and saying to John Ridley, do the show you want to do.
Yes.
Make it the way you want to, and we'll let the audience decide.
And he's busy. He has a movie coming out, too. Mm-hmm. He's been really busy. I have to give it another chance because it kind of went over my head a little bit. I think I watched the first episode, and I was like, You know, so I'm going to have to give it another chance.
Yes, but and the cast is tremendous.
Cast, oh my gosh, the cast, you can't miss it. It was a storyline I wasn't sure about. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the cast is amazing. There's some great work going on out there. You know, our cast is phenomenal. Besides Deborah Messing's fans, you know, our talent pool has been amazing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. We are speaking with Alysia Joy Powell. She's one of the co-stars of The Mysteries of Laura. You can find it Wednesday nights at 8 o'clock on NBC. And she is right now live in our studio this half hour on Tomorrow Be Televised. Simon Applebaum here with you. Delighted you're with us on this Monday afternoon. 64 degrees at the top of the hour here in New Eva, York. You have a question or comment for Alysia? Don't be shy. Ring in 646-652-2906 or use our chat room, SimonApple04 by name. Monday on Tomorrow Be Televised, most of our guests will be live right here in our studio, as Alysia is now. First up, we'll have the creator and chief executive of an organization that wants to be the Netflix of multicultural television. It's called Collide.tv, and as we speak, they're out to raise $150,000 to turn their website, which has been around for a year, into a television network on smart TVs or on devices like Roku, Chromecast, and Amazon Fire TV. Latif Salud, he will join us, and we hope to have maybe one of the producers of his program. Then, about a year ago, we introduced you to a show called People Like Us, people like you. And it's a series that took place here in New York, started out as a TV show, became a web series by John Dillon De La Torre and Baltimore Russell. This month, the series went live on television through Here TV. And John and Baltimore will be back with us live. That's all coming up Monday, 3 p.m. Eastern, noon Pacific, right here on Tomorrow Be Televised. Now, as you wait for NBC to make its call on Laura, there's a couple things you're doing. I understand it's not just acting, it's being behind the camera, too.
I do. I direct as well. I direct, I write. I'm working on a feature film. I'm also working on a one-woman show. I have a jewelry line where I make jewelry by hand. I'm wearing one of my pieces today. Also a clothing line that
For those of you, by the way, on Blog Talk Radio, I see the jewelry. It's beautiful, like red. Coral pieces.
Yeah. And a clothing line, too, in the fall. Mm-hmm. So I'm a little busy.
Now, something else we're going to show this in a moment is a film you did called The Sitter.
Yes. Yes, I did, with Jonah Hill. Mm-hmm.
And I believe one of the people from Orange is the New Black is also in it.
Yes. Samaria Wiley. Mm-hmm. Yes. She was awesome to work with. She was just starting out then, which is amazing. Her career has just shot out.
How long ago did you do this film?
The Sitter, I think, was about 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah, about 3 or 4 years ago.
Hmm. Yes. And tell us about the movie and the character you play.
I play a store clerk who encounters Jonah Hill's character, and he's with this little girl, and I think he's a child molester because he's looking at panties. Mm. And I'm going to get in. I'm going to get him. Mm. Not take him down.
Yeah, deserves taking down from what you're saying.
Literally, I tried to take him down.
You think about, you know, as you're doing Laura, that, hey, maybe I'd like to write, direct an episode of this, or if not Laura, something else on television?
I would. I really would, because my background, I'm from California. My dad was an actor before me. Mm-hmm. So my background has been more film and TV than it has been theater. Mm-hmm. I love theater. I love live. But I am more geared to film and TV, and I would love to. And I've been picking the brains of those directors when I get on the set.
What's your father's name, and how did he influence you as not only an actress, but as a writer-director in terms of dealing with entertainment?
His name is Jay Scorpio. Actually, him and my mom influenced me a lot. They met in an acting class, and they've been incredibly supportive in my career. Also, they taught me the business of acting. You know, always 10% show, 90% business. And so I'm very much aware about the business side of our entertainment business. But I've been writing since I was in the sixth grade. So it's not a new thing to me. It's something that's always been around, but now just taking advantage of those thoughts and all the things that I've been writing and collaborating them together and making, you know, projects.
Who are your role models?
I have individual people that I look up to. Jeffrey Wright is one of my all-time favorite
extraordinary actors.
Oh my gosh. And nobody knows who he is. That's how good he is. You know, he's such a chameleon.
He's one of those people that you know the name, you know the face.
Yes, but you don't know the name. Yes. He's amazing. I love actors who can transform into a character. Ruben Santiago.
Lackawanna Blues.
Yes.
Which he wrote
for
HBO, won the Emmy Award several years ago for HBO.
More than his acting, his directing. Oh my gosh. I was sitting in the front row of a piano lesson and almost peed my pants. Oh my gosh, I had like a hallelujah moment there. He's an amazing director. Amazing director. Those are people who, you know, Debbie Allen. There's different people. Clint Eastwood. There's people that, you know, that just blow my mind what they can do. And like, I pay attention to everything. Even watching Empire, I was like, that's a good shot selection right there. That's a good camera angle.
Debbie did one of those episodes. I have been
a Debbie Allen
admirer.
She did the last episode.
Ever since I've been a Debbie made her TV debut on an NBC series, which was a series of four or five called Three Girls Three. And when you saw her dance on that show, you knew this was somebody very special. But if you've seen her career grow from that to fame, then a different world, then going behind the scenes on that show, and now directing all sorts of things, including a wonderful and frankly a movie that should have gotten more play this past year called Black Chocolate Christmas, Black Chocolate Nutcracker,
yes.
BET this December.
Yes.
Wonderful directing talent.
She does that every year because she has a dance studio in L.A., and she does that show every year. This is the first time that they televised it.
Wonderful film.
Yeah.
And I wish the critics had given it more play.
Yeah, she's brilliant. She's brilliant. I just hope to be half of that brilliance.
So do you have anything lined up as you await, specifically as you await the decision on Laura?
My one-woman show. My one-woman show, I'm working on that now. I will be in North Carolina with it at the Black Theater Festival in Winston-Salem. I'm working on that now. And whatever comes my way, I'm looking for somebody to holler back.
Okay. Well, you can holler back to Alysia this Wednesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Pacific Time on The Mysteries of Laura, starring Deborah Messing and produced here in New York on NBC. Check your local leads for the NBC station in your area that carries the program. And for more details online, NBC.com. That is where you go. Alysia, thank you for this half hour. It's been fantastic.
Thank you. You're wonderful.
And all the very best to you. And hopefully, keep the fingers crossed that NBC makes the call.
Second season, yes.
Absolutely. And before Alysia leaves us and we leave this segment, we're going to leave you with a scene from The Sitter. Thanks, Alysia, again.
Thank you so much.
Here's The Sitter.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, what's uh-oh?
I sharted.
Oh!
Hey, Noah. Oh my God, isn't this shirt so cute?
Oh, it's super cute.
Seriously?
No, here. Put these on.
Ew, you're green. I wouldn't be caught dead in these.
Put them on. All right? I don't care.
Can I help you, sir?
Huh?
Can I help you?
I'm just waiting for somebody.
No, that's pretty weird, considering you're a grown-ass man hanging out in the little girl's underwear section.
There she is.
Excuse me, young lady. Do you know this person?
No.
Yeah.
He came into my house and stole my mom's minivan. Now he's taking me and my brothers to get some candy.
That sounds way, way worse than it actually is.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
I'm the babysitter.
What?
He's not a real babysitter. He's a do whatever I say or I'll kill you type of babysitter.
Why are you hanging out in the little girl's clothes section?
Can you please lower your voice? There are numerous misunderstandings happening.
I'm not buying none of this.
You gotta buy. No.
Where are you going?
Nowhere.